There is a lovely piece of mathematics called the fold and cut theorem that says if you take any shape where it's just made of straight lines, it's possible to fold a piece of paper in such a way that a single cut will remove that shape. My friend Katie Stuckles did a fantastic Numberphile video on this, where she showed how to fold and cut every single letter in the English alphabet. What I've just done is kind of the classic fold and cut. That's where you make a single snip, and when you unfold the shape, you've got yourself a five-pointed star. Come on, there it is. Aha, look at that. However, given it's pretty much Halloween, I thought I would show you a fold and cut I came up with myself. So I'm currently on tour with my show Humble Pie, and I thought I'll just take a few minutes to show you how to fold and cut a bat. I'm all set up so you can see what I'm doing on the side. I'm going to start with an A4 piece of paper and fold it in half like this. It doesn't have to be A4. Anything suitably similar in terms of rectangles of paper will be fine. You'll just end up with a subtly different bat. In fact, that's going to be a reoccurring theme. So I folded it up, and now the bottom bit here where the fold is, I'm going to just dog ear that corner. And oh, okay, you know what, spoiler, the actual shape of that little triangle and the angle it's on, that makes a big difference to the final shape of the bat. So experiment with different triangles. Once you've got something that you're semi-satisfied with, you flip the whole thing over this way, and here, there's the bit I folded over. I'm going to fold about a centimeter worth of that back, and I'm going to call that, this is the business fold. Okay, because here I'm layering the paper up. Eventually I'm going to cut through this to get my bat. The rest of it, easy enough. I now take the top of the business end. Here, so there's the business fold. There's the top bit. I'm going to fold, like imagine a line going across to this corner over here. I'm going to get that whole section and fold it over and in. Again, close enough is good enough. You just get a subtly different bat. Now, that's kind of like a kite. Would you accept a kite shape for, yeah, sort of? A very, you know, jaunty kite. Imagine the hat of the kite, this bit up here, and I got to imagine a line across there. I'm going to fold that back like that. And so now I've got, here's all the business end, all the folding, and then actually if you look at the triangle we just folded back, you've got the business folding over here and you've got the boring corner. I'm going to take the boring corner and see if, this doesn't always work, see if I can fold it all the way underneath and get it to poke out the, oh there it is, you can see, just poking out the side there. Once you've got it poking out the side, I tend to slide it down so it's kind of in line, like the shortest distance across from where the business end touches that fold, let's call it there. Right, and then I fold that last crease there. And that's it. Those are all the folds. In theory, we're one cut away from a bat. So the cut is parallel to the bottom. So you can imagine there's the bottom there. You slide it up and you cut through. You can see where the paper there just wraps underneath. So that contact point there, the corner of this little triangle here, I'm going to cut, boom, straight through there. So here we go, line it up. That's pretty much it, straight through that point. Through the other side. Oh, that takes a serious bit of cutting. I don't want to lose that. The other bit can fly off. There we go. Okay, so now we're left with this little bit here. If we unfold, 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 and we end up with, come on, that is totally a bat. Look at that. There is our Halloween bat with one cut. And because it's the fold and cut theorem, I can actually unfold the rest of it, and it gives me a negative bat. Whoa, even more terrifying. Negative bat. You may have noticed there was a lot of close enough is good enough in that, because I just wanted to make a bat and I just kind of worked it out as I went along. So as a bit of a bonus, I'm going to show you how I originally worked that out. So I've got a bit of paper here. I knew the bat was going to be symmetric, so I folded it in half. Now all of these things, the folding up the corner there, the dog ear, the flipping it over and folding it back, that's doing the bat's ears. And then this bit here where we fold that up, that's bringing the bat's body to line up with the bat's wings. And actually if I unfold that, you can get a better sense of what's going on. And I've got this so I can draw on it with a Sharpie without accidentally drawing on the table. So you could imagine, let's say here, this is our bat's ears. There's an ear there. There's an ear there. And then, you know what? Let's make this subtly different. Let's say we want, so I've got wings which have like a they're like parallel-ish, and then they got like a tip. Let's say we want big, pointy bat wings like that. Oh, that's pretty exciting. And then we'll have like a body down here, maybe a bit at the bottom. Okay, that's a bit different. I'm not gonna draw on this side. Oh, you know what? We'll draw on this side. In theory, it's gonna be the reflection of that. I've drawn it subtly different. We'll decide which one we want to cut out as we go along. So when I originally fold it in half, let's see if I can get it over there like that. So the first fold in was to get the ears onto the ears. So that folds onto there, close enough. And then when you fold it back, I'm getting there that. I'm mapping it over onto that line there. So now when I cut out that bit of the wing, I will actually cut out the ears of the bat. If you can hear some noise in the background, it's the people getting ready for tonight's show, as I should be. Anyway, so this fold here, in theory, brings that up onto there. Okay, there's the other one I've drawn. It's not quite as good. That'll be fine. Now, if we want to do a subtly different bat, let's take this line here we want to cut out and fold it down onto that one like that. Now, I've got these two lines. I've just got to get one of them onto the other one. So that's probably going to be a fold like... No, that's not quite... Oh, that's because I've drawn them a bit different on each side. Let's just do this one and hope for the best. Okay, so I've done that. So here we are, different bats. I'm going to cut all the way along this line here and see what we end up with. So to work it out, I just did loads and loads of drawing and folding and cutting and unfolding and then changing and drawing again. And oh, you eventually tweak it into the bat you want. Oh, look at that. Oh, I don't know if that's the bat we deserve, but it's the bat we need right now. Look at that. So this time I've got pointy wings as opposed to before I had like the wings with a bit on the end, and it's a different body. Okay, so your challenge is see if you can find a better fold and cut bat than any of the ones I've come up with. I will put the directions for my original bat below. So that's how to make a fold and cut bat. Instructions are below, but I'm sure you can do better. I should hurry up and do my show now, so I'm pretty much set. That's my pack lectern, my Pacton, which I'm very proud of. And on the other side over there, that's a arcade emulation of Pac-Man. We have it crash on level 256 live on stage. If you want to come and see the show, I'm doing it all around the UK, October and November 2019. I'd love to see you there. I say hello to the audience after the show. It'll be great to meet everyone. And if you're in North America, don't panic. I'll be doing some North American dates, USA, maybe Canada, in early 2020. So keep an eye out for that. And due to popular demand, I'll be doing more shows around the UK in April 2020. So bigger and better venues. Keep an eye out for that. I'll do a proper announcement when they go on sale. But for now, I've got like 20 more shows across October and November. And we've sold out all the shows so far. This is show 5. I'm in the Roses Theatre in Tewkesbury. So hopefully we'll fill this tonight. It wasn't sold out as of this afternoon, so who knows. Don't forget, if you're a Patreon supporter of a certain level, you get free tickets, and all supporters of every type, I'd love to see you at the shows. The meet and greet afterwards, I hang around and I say hello to everyone who wants a selfie and wants to get their calculator signed. See you here.